Hello students, welcome to today's session. So today we are going to discuss increment and decrement operators. So what are these operators? See, while programming or making a software, often you'll come across situations where you'd want to increase or decrease a variable's value by 1. Okay, for example, let's say I have stored 10 in x. Okay, I have stored the value 10 in variable x. Now for some reason I would like to either increase the value of the variable x by 1, or I might want to decrease the value of the variable x by 1. Okay, so this is how you would do it, isn't it? To increase the value by 1, you will write x is equal to x plus 1, which will make the value of x as 11. Similarly, if you want to decrease the value of x by 1, you'll write x is equal to x minus 1, which would make the value of x as 9. Okay, so can you think of a situation where this might be needed? Well, let's take the example of Facebook. Okay, let's say I don't have an account in Facebook. So what I will do is I'll create a new account and I'll fill this form and click on sign up. Okay, so as soon as I fill up all the valid details and click on sign up, what will happen? A new user, that is me, okay, a new user will be created in the database of Facebook. Okay, and the number of user will increase by 1, isn't it? As soon as I sign up, the total number of users of Facebook will increase by 1. Okay, and how will Facebook do this? How will Facebook keep track of it? Okay, so Facebook will have already stored the total number of users so far. Okay, and as soon as I click on sign up, so Facebook will update that particular value by 1. It will increase the value by 1. Okay, and in another scenario, let's say I want to delete my account from Facebook. Okay, so what will Facebook do? Facebook will delete my account and it will decrease the total number of users by 1, isn't it? So let's say Facebook is using the variable name for tracking the total number of users. Okay, let's say the variable name Facebook is using is total number of users. Okay, so it will be some number. Okay, for the sake of simplicity, let's say 985. Okay, let's say Facebook, just assume, okay, that the total number of users at this point in time is 985. Okay, so as soon as I sign up, what would Facebook do? Facebook will update the total number of users, isn't it? And how will it update? It will update by writing this statement: total number of users is equal to total number of users plus 1. That means the current value of total number of users is 985. So this This will return 985. So 985 plus 1 would give you 986. And finally, the value will be updated for total number of users, that is 986. Okay. Similarly, if let's say the total number of users now it is 86, 986. Okay. And if I delete my account, so Facebook will do this calculation, isn't it? Total number of users is equal to total number of users minus 1. So the current value of total number of users is 986. So 986 minus 1 will bring the value to 985, and 985 will be assigned to total number of users. Okay. So this was just an example, a practical example where you might want to use this increment of a variable by one, or decrement of a variable's value by one. Okay, let's keep some simple variable name now. So let's say int x is equal to 1. So instead of writing x is equal to x plus 1, this statement can be written as x plus plus. Okay. So the shorter way of writing x is equal to x plus 1 is this, x plus plus. Or you can also write plus plus x. So both of them are same. Okay. This one will also perform x is equal to x plus 1, and this statement will also perform x is equal to x plus 1. Okay. And for decreasing, you can either write x minus minus, or you can write minus minus x. Okay. So let's write x plus plus and print the value of x. So the value will be two, right? X was 1 initially, and x plus plus increased the value of x by 1, hence this is printing the value of x as 2. Okay. Let's say I write instead of x plus plus, I write here plus plus x. So if I write plus plus x, again I will have the same output, as you can see. Okay. Now let's see decrement. Okay, let's write x minus minus, and let's change this value to 15, just an example. So x is 15 initially, and x minus minus will decrease the value by 1. So what will be the output of x? The output will be 14. Okay, x minus minus has decreased the value of x by 1. Similarly, I can write minus minus x. It will do the same thing. Okay. So again, you can see that the value of x is 14. Now, let's see the terminologies used for plus plus x, x plus plus, minus minus x, and x minus minus. So this is known as If you are writing the plus plus symbol before the variable name, it is known as pre-increment. Okay? See, pre means before. So, pre-increment means before increment. And this is x plus plus. The plus plus sign is coming after the variable name. So, it is known as post-increment. Okay? So, let's say if I say pre-independence, that means what? Before independence. And if I say post-independence, that means what? After independence. Okay. So pre means before and post means after. And what will be this? What can we call this? This will be pre-decrement, right? And this will be post decrement. So I hope the terms used for these kind of operations is clear. Now, the next thing is that these operators are unary operators. Okay. Now recall, what are unary operators? Unary operators are those operators which take just one operand. Okay. So you can see here that plus plus is taking only one operand, isn't it? That is x. Here also it's taking one operand, minus minus x. So in all the four situations, you can see that only one operand is being used. So this is the second point to remember. The next point is that the order of writing, of using, see, as long as you have the statement by itself, okay? That means if the statement is not a part of another expression, so it will not make any difference whether you use plus plus x or x plus plus. Similarly, it will not make any difference if you use minus minus x or x minus minus. This is the case when the statement, when the pre-increment or the post-increment or the pre-decrement and the post-decrement, they are by themselves. They are not part of any other expression. Okay. In that case, they will behave exactly the same. Okay. And they won't have any unwanted implications in the program. But as soon as the post-increment or pre-increment or post-decrement and pre-decrement, as soon as they become part of some other expression, the operation slightly changes. Okay, so let's have a look. Let's say I write int y is equal to x plus plus. So what will happen here? Now this x plus plus statement is not standalone. It's not by itself. It is part of the larger expression, that is int y is equal to x plus plus. So in this scenario, you have to be careful. You have to understand how it will work. See, this is post increment, right? In post increment, the value of x will be used first. Okay, the old value will be used first. So what is the old value of x? Old value of x is 15. That means 15 will be assigned to y. Okay. And then the value of x will increase by 1. Okay. So let me print the value of y. So y is equal to y, and so as you can see, the value of y is 15, isn't it? Y is 15 and x is 16. So what happened here? The old value of x was assigned to y, and then the value of x was increased by 1. So the old value was 15, that is why y became 15, and the final value of x will be 16 because it was incremented by 1. Okay, so this is how post increment works. Now let's see pre-increment. So in pre-increment, okay, pre-increment means first update the value, okay, first update the value of x. So what will happen? X is 15. So if you update the value of x, that is 16. Okay, that 16 will become the value of y. Okay, so pre-increment means update then use. Update then use. This was what? First use then update. First use then update. This will be first update then use. Okay, so first update, that means x will become 16. 16 is assigned to y and x is also 16, right? So both the values will be 16. So you can see that both x and y, they are 16. Okay, y is also 16 and x is also 16. Let's take the example of post decrement. So post decrement means what? First use then decrement. Okay, see, just by looking at the statement here, x minus minus, see, first the variable is coming, okay, then increment is decrement is there, right? So just by looking at it, you can remember it that first use the value, first use the old value, okay, and then decrement. First use the old value and then decrement. So what is the old value? 15. So 15 gets assigned to y, and then x is decremented by 1, so it will become 14. That is, y is 15 and x becomes 14. Okay, so the output should be 15 and 14. Okay, so the output is here. Okay, let's see minus minus x. So minus minus x is what? It is pre-decrement. Okay, so minus minus x, first decrement and then use. Okay, first decrement the value and then you will use the new value. Okay, so first decrement it, x was 15, so it will become 14. That 14 will get assigned to y, and x is also 14. Okay, that means both x and y should be 14 now. So you can see the output, y is also 14 and x is also 14. Now let us make some complex expressions here. Okay, let us just use two terms. Okay, so what have I written? X plus plus minus 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 x. Okay, so let's try to solve this. What is the value of x? See, it is x plus plus, that means first use the value, first use the old value, and then increment the value of x. So first use, okay, first use, that means 15 will come here, okay, and then x will become 16. Okay, then minus, this time we have minus minus x, right? So minus minus, first decrement. So what is the value of x? It is, remember, it is not 15 now. The value of x is updated to 16. So first decrement it, then use it. Okay. So if you decrement 16, it will become 15, right? So 15 will come here. And 15 minus 15 is 0, right? So 0 will get assigned to y. And what is the value of x? The last value of x was 15. So the output should be 0 and 15. Let's have a look. So as you can see, y is 0 and x is 15. Now let me modify the expression again. Let's say I write here plus 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 x minus x minus minus. Okay, so we have got a new expression here. So let's try to solve this. So x value is 15, so 15 will come here, okay, and x will be updated to 16, okay, so minus this minus, okay, minus it's first, this is what, this is pre-decrement, isn't it? So first decrease the value of x, so decrease it, that is 15. Okay, now x is also what, 15, right? Then plus 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 x, that means first increase the value of x, so first increase the value of x, so x will become 16 again. Okay, it is 16 again, and that new value will be used. Okay, minus, use the value of x first, so x is what, x is the latest value is 16, and then decrease the value of x. Okay, so x will become 15. Okay, so if you calculate this, 15 minus 15 is 0 and 16 minus 16 is also 0. So again y will be assigned with the value of 0 and x will remain what? It will remain 15. Okay, so the output again will be 0 and 15. Okay, now let us change the expression again. So y plus equals Okay, so as soon as you see this kind of expression, okay, where shorthand assignment operator has been used, first you should expand it. Okay, so if you expand it, it will become, so expand it, this will become y is equal to y plus x plus 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 minus minus y. Okay, so y plus equals x means what? Y is equal to y plus x. So this is what I've done here. Okay, this is y is equal to y, and this whole expression you can consider as what? X, and rest is same, isn't it? So, let's put in the values here. Y is 3, right? Y is 3 plus x plus plus. So the value of x is what? Value of x is 5. So 5 will come here, and then it will increment. So x will become what? 6. Okay, plus minus minus y, that means decrement first, isn't it? Decrement the value of y first. What is y? Y is 3, so it will become 2. Okay, and then use the value 2. Okay, so 3 plus 5 is 8, 8 plus 2 is 10. Okay, and this 10 value will be assigned where? It will be assigned to where? To y. Okay, so y should become 10, and x should be 6. Okay, according to our calculation, the final value of x is 6, and the value of y is 10. So 10 and 6. Let's compile. So as you can see, output is as expected. Y is 10 and x is 6. So I hope you get the idea. This is how post increment and pre post increment, pre increment, then post decrement and pre decrement. This is how it works. Okay. So one last point I would like to mention here, that the operand for plus plus or minus minus should always be a variable. You cannot write a constant. Okay, you cannot write something like 5 plus plus and expect it to produce 6. Okay, so this is not allowed. Okay, this is not allowed. The operand for these operators, that is plus plus and minus minus, should always be a variable. Should always be a variable. Okay, so that's it for increment and decrement operators. Thank you.